Hi there, and welcome to this Alesis Drums tutorial. Today, you'll learn the basics of drum trigger settings for the Alesis Command and Crimson drum modules, and how and why to adjust them. First, let's go over why it's important to know how to adjust your kit's trigger settings. Every Alesis drum kit ships with a standard set of settings, which is meant to be as general as possible to be playable by drummers of all genres and skill levels. It's both normal and recommended to adjust your kit's settings to suit your playing style. This is a gradual process, and most drummers tune their kit slowly over time and make small adjustments as needed. Now, let's dive into adjusting the trigger settings on the Command and Crimson modules. I'll be using a Command module in this video, but everything we cover will also apply to the Crimson module. Power on the module, and it'll default to the Kit Selection page. If you aren't currently viewing this page, press the Kit button. Press the Menu button to enter the Kit menu, then use the down button until trigger is highlighted, then press enter. Next, hit the pad of the drum voice you want to edit. You'll see the name of the pad appear at the top of the module's display, and its current trigger settings will be shown below. To edit a parameter, use the up and down buttons to select it, then use the dial to increase or decrease the parameter's value. Not all parameters will be relevant to all pads, so some will display two hyphens instead of a number when they don't apply to the currently selected pad. Sensitivity controls the sensitivity of a pad's drum head. A higher sensitivity value will yield louder hits with less force, and a lower sensitivity value will require more force to yield quieter hits. Rim sensitivity controls the sensitivity of a pad's rim. Hit the rim of one of the drum pads that has a rim zone to access this setting for that pad. Just like the sensitivity setting, a higher value produces louder hits with less force, and a lower value requires more force to produce quieter hits. Head rim adjust controls the amount of crosstalk reduction between a pad's head and rim. Crosstalk refers to the transfer of force when hitting a pad, and how hitting a pad can sometimes also trigger its rim voice to play at the same time. A higher value will reduce the probability that the pad's rim voice will be triggered when you hit the head, and vice versa. However, keep in mind that if this value is set too high, you might not be able to trigger the pad's voice if you intentionally hit both the head and rim simultaneously, and the voice may be silenced due to the module perceiving the hit as crosstalk. Threshold controls the amount of force needed to trigger the pad's voice. A low value will trigger the voice with a very light hit, while a high value will require more force to trigger its voice. Crosstalk controls the amount of crosstalk reduction between different pads. This is similar in concept to the head rim adjust setting, but instead of only applying to a single pad's head and rim, this parameter applies to the entire kit, as the transfer of force while playing the kit can travel through the drum rack or floor and cause unwanted triggers from pads that aren't being hit. Just like the head rim adjust setting, if this value is set too high, hitting multiple pads at the same time may result in some of them being silenced, as the module will interpret the simultaneous hits as crosstalk. Curve controls the pad's velocity curve. This determines the relationship between how hard you hit the pad and the volume of the drum voice that's triggered. Retrig cancel controls the amount of time between consecutive pad hits to play the voice for both hits. A high value for this parameter will cause the module to ignore rapid successive hits. MIDI note controls which MIDI notes will be triggered by each pad when the module is connected to a computer or other external MIDI device via its USB MIDI port or MIDI out output. If you're just using the kit by itself, this setting won't affect any of the drum triggers or voices. And finally, splash sensitivity controls the hi-hat pedal's sensitivity for triggering a hi-hat splash voice instead of the pedal's usual closed hi-hat voice. Setting this parameter to a high value will increase the likelihood that lightly tapping the hi-hat pedal will produce the splash voice. And remember, after adjusting each setting, make sure to press the Save button to save your changes. Otherwise, the trigger settings will revert back to their factory values after restarting the module. Before we wrap up, let's learn how to perform a factory reset on the Command and Crimson modules. This can come in handy if you're unhappy with multiple trigger settings and simply want to start from scratch. Keep in mind that doing this will cause all settings to be reset to their default values. While the unit is powered off, press and hold both arrow buttons, then press the power button. After displaying the Alesis logo, the screen will say Factory Resetting. And after a few seconds, your module will redirect to the home screen, confirming that its settings have been reverted back to their factory values. So, now that you're armed with the basics on adjusting your module's trigger settings, I encourage you to experiment with them until you've found a setup that best fits your playing style. For more resources on using your Alesis drum kit, be sure to check out the other videos in our Alesis support playlist, and head over to alesis.com/support, where you'll find the Alesis knowledge base and a portal to reach out to the Alesis technical support team if you need further assistance. Thanks as always for watching.